Let's kick this shit.
We do not always get Jersey Jack pinball releases, but when we do, it comes like this. If you had one song from Guns N' Roses to describe your life, I'm putting you on the spot, what would that song be?
Don't you cry.
I'm trying to think what mine would be.
November Rain.
Oh, I do like November Rain.
November Rain's freaking beautiful. You know what I love? I love Civil War. That is one of my favorite songs. You don't like that song?
Chinese Democracy, maybe?
Yeah, like it's weird. Like I like Civil War. I think I enjoy it. I enjoy that song. I don't know why. I love the whistling.
What about Welcome to the Jungle?
You wanted the best? Well, they couldn't make it. From Hollywood, Guns and Roses!
Welcome to the Jungle.
Now it's getting fun.
A little played out for me.
We got fun and games.
But I enjoy it.
I would say live or let die, damn it.
Yeah.
Because if you won't let me live, then you might as well kill me.
Yep.
Maybe that's what I'd go with.
That's pretty fantastic. So what are we doing?
We're going to do a first impressions because we have had this special opportunity. to go up early
yep.
and to play Guns N' Roses, designed by Eric Menier. This is his second game, his follow-up to Pirates of the Caribbean, which has been critically acclaimed. This Jersey Jack Pinball, this is Keith Johnson and Joe Katz, a little tag team there. Original hand-drawn artwork by a newcomer in pinball, as well as an artist, many artists that do the illustrations and the posters for the Guns N' Roses band. This game is full assets. It was co-designed by one of the biggest and most iconic rock superstars of all time, Slash. He is a co-designer with Eric Menier. All assets, all songs, all animation by JP DeWin and team. And then you also have concert footage. It's there's so much to take in, so much innovation here. But we've put a lot of games on this.
Yes.
These people are watching this, and they haven't put their hands on it yet.
No.
So we are here to guide them, if you will, to the Paradise City that is Guns N' Roses. First walked into the new factory of Jersey Jack Pinball in Elk Grove Village, Chicagoland area, Illinois. You saw this game, Greg. What well, did what caught your eye first?
I gotta tell you a quick story though, real quick. So I'm stepping out of my car and Eric Menier's coming across the parking lot, and I thought he was coming out to greet me.
Oh yeah.
I was like, oh, I'm special.
Like, hey.
Thank you, Eric. But no, he was like, hey, I'm going to get lunch. I don't want you to see this game or touch it until I get back from getting lunch.
You got there before I did.
And I was like, what the hell?
What am I supposed to do?
Zach was running a little behind, so I was like, because I was going to go in. I wanted to just play the shit out of it while I was waiting on Zach. And so I just had to stand around and wait.
Set up gear, maybe. How about that?
Yeah. Me and Ken walked around, and Ken Cromwell, who works in their marketing and department there. And me and Ken went around. We were scouting some shot areas and stuff to set up for our interviews and so forth and everything, and just kind of gave me a quick tour of the factory and their new setup, which was phenomenal.
They got a nice new setup there.
Very much so. And I got to see the cabinet, and I will tell you, I did have a first impression seeing the cabinet, because they were on the line.
On the line.
And it was the concert posters. And when I was...
That's the LE.
Yes, the LE. And that when that was first unveiled to me, because we'd seen shots of some of this stuff. We'd seen Playfield... I guess.
We've been working with Jersey Jack for a little bit of time.
And then the cabinet. And we'd seen some of the brief other pieces of art and so forth. In the cabinet, I was like, man, I don't know if I'm wild about that poster art, like poster slapped and where. I don't know if that
the actual
what I wanted posters. To see it. Yep. Yeah, but in person, that is my favorite package.
Really,
I love the posters. They are so much better, okay. And it looks so much cooler because it fits the game. I was like, how are you?
Artwork.
Yeah, I was okay. Like, how are you going to do a play field around this?
Yeah, I could see that
and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And then we got to see the game, the play field,
mm-hmm.
Everything put together.
Yeah. I want to play it right now.
What'd you think about it?
Whenever I first saw the artwork, I like the LA. I think that is solid.
Mm-hmm.
It's maybe no Zombie Yeti, but it is solid. You were saying you didn't like the standard as much artwork. I like that. I thought it was cool, the cartoon kind of stuff.
Yeah.
I haven't seen one in person. Yeah, we have.
Yeah.
We have. I haven't seen the whole machine in person, but the collector's edition mm-hmm. artwork on this, I think it's Appetite for mm-hmm. Destruction, kind of the machine versus mm-hmm. this. Oh, but the chrome cabinet art.
Yeah.
Yep.
I'll tell you what the LE, I'll tell you why. Of what separates it from me and why I like it. I like a good throwback game. I feel like that Stearns and everything are so colorful mm-hmm. these days and so vibrant. I like the toned down.
This is more rich.
Rich yeah. color. Exactly. Rich
it's got
colors
grunge,
of that.
But
exactly.
It is very refined.
Yes,
grungy,
yes,
but
yeah, it's not, it does, but Hobbit was same, Hobbit, you know, a lot of older Bally games were the same yeah. way and stuff, and this to me is one of the, like, closest that they have gotten to an old Bally game.
Wow, okay.
In every aspect, mm-hmm. but that's why I like that more, it's a lot of art, and there's a lot going on, obviously, in those concert posters, but it's not just in-your-face bright colors all over the cab.
The playfield's pretty bright.
The playfield is bright. And the lighting, like,
I think the hand work. Like, finally, Jersey Jack Pinball, we get some hand-drawn artwork.
Oh, so
some
pretty.
Stylistic mm-hmm. Choices that these artists make.
Mm-hmm.
The bottom third of those skeletons with Axel, right?
Oh.
And then you got Slash all in skeletal mm-hmm. form. Mid-playfield with the map and stuff, that's fair. But
does the map not look better? Like, I thought the map took up such a lot of real estate that I was kind of like, well, it's like a damn globe on there.
You gotta
like,
see
yeah,
person.
Something's
yeah.
just not right about that. Why did they do that? But it's a major part of the game.
Mm-hmm.
The map is.
Yep. All the cities are laid out
exactly.
with LEDs. And
but it doesn't. It feels cohesive with everything else on
it
there.
It might be a little too busy if it were anything else in
exactly.
the
middle. Exactly. Yeah. So it fits very well and works in person
this
phenomenally.
This game is hyper energy.
Beyond.
Hyper energy. Beyond. You try to play this game calm.
Beyond. Yep.
Yeah, it feels like you're at a concert. Yep. Eric Menier, we saw in our promo, say that he was trying to, one, establish and mm-hmm. create the greatest music-based
mm-hmm.
pinball machine of all time. Right,
yeah.
And he wanted the player, you, mm-hmm. to experience the Guns N' Roses concert from a pinball machine.
Yes.
So we get things like a 27-inch screen yeah. with them performing on it, then mm-hmm. the Jumbotron in the back of the game.
Yes.
You get with the actual assets
on
from
the
LE
and everything. You have moving stage light, roving stage lights.
Yes, can lights. Oh. You got that. You've got
And I'll tell you what, that's not something, that's not a narrative that, again, first impression, stepping up and flipping it. Not only, like, when you see the game, are you overwhelmed with all the shots, all the cool stuff, the sculpts, everything else. But when you flip that game, that's not a narrative that you need to be told or have explained to you.
No.
Like, I do, like, when you step up there, you go, holy shit. This is like I'm at their concert. Like, between the roving, you know, stage lights, the can lights, everything blashing.
When you start a song in this game, Greg.
The light rails, the drumsticks, like everything. The cymbals on the pops.
The neck of the guitar.
Yes.
The spinning disc that makes the entire LEDs spin.
And with the Jumbotron. All on
dude,
the freaking
even got the hexagon lights in the back.
Yes.
That were the same as on the GNR stage.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. Like they do not need to set that narrative in your mind.
The integration
it's
on
there.
This it's close to like the Hobbit.
Yes.
Like it, that's
hands down, it is sickening.
It fucking rocks. It just rocks. Some of the innovations that I've seen in this. I know what they were talking about, innovation. Now, you get your Wi-Fi, right?
Yeah.
Get your Wi-Fi out of the box. You've got Bluetooth headphone speakers now.
Yeah.
These hot rails, these patented mm-hmm. Eric Menier genius creation hot rails.
When I was told about the hot rails, you know me, I thought
a lot of these people thought the same thing.
And I was
worried.
I was like, okay, like they're like Penn Stadiums or something. Yeah. You're like, no, they actually shine up at you. And I'm like,
yeah, it's even worse.
God, why? I don't want something. I don't want it in my eyes. I don't want it blinding me. I don't want it strobing in my face. So when I was told that, I was like, well, that's a deal killer for me. But I also talked to two people who'd played it.
Yeah.
And there was no complaints of it. But I'm a unique, very reserved individual when it comes to my eyes.
Do you like lube them up at night?
Yeah. I was like, do I need some glasses? Like, what am I going to need?
Your pin shades.
Not at all.
No.
Not at all. It does not affect your eyes. Like so I'm going to...
Unless you have, like, epilepsy.
I thought Star Trek...
To be fair.
I think Star Trek is one of the brightest fucking games
it
out there.
It flashes in your
and it's in my face. I actually had to remove some damn flashers out of Star Trek. Like, I hate it. That's how anal and weird I am about that shit. This does none of that, even in the dark, because we played it. I got to play it in like a fully lit factory, and then we got to play it in a dark room. Mm-hmm. And in the dark room, it was not harsh on the eyes at all, at all.
But in the promos, it looks like it would blind you.
Yes, like okay,
it's oh my god.
You know the annoyance. Like I love Lethal Weapon 3. Like a lot of Data East games, Sega games, just always in your like strobing. It's nothing like that. Even during everything exploding and going off, it's not the strobe light effect that it looks like.
So the Hot Rails are a winner for you?
A fucking fantastic winner.
It's probably...
I've never seen a light show like this in my entire life.
There's no light show like
this. No, it's impossible.
This makes Wizard of Oz light show, which many herald as the greatest light show in pinball, it makes it look like amateur hour.
Yeah.
I'm
Dialed In had a good light show.
Sure, that's hyperbole. But this is easily, any other manufacturer would agree, this is easily the best light-coated game in history.
Ever.
In history.
Ever. By leaps and bounds.
It's its own character.
Yes.
It pulls you in as well as the music pulls you in.
Yep.
The lighting, the hot rails. I've never seen a feature. All year, we've had a lot of releases.
Mm-hmm.
There's not been one feature yet, Greg, like hot rails.
No. No.
You've got to see them in real life. They tell the story and they pull in all the ambience of the lighting you're looking for.
Because it just seems like if you were to have it explained to you, and you've got the like you said, the hexagonal stage lights in the back going off, you've got the can lights going off, you've got the hot rails going off, you got the rest of the GI, it sounds overwhelming, but it's not. It's literally like being at a real concert where it sets the stage, it sets the atmosphere. It doesn't hinder anything. It does nothing.
Yeah,
but
you're gonna complain about the sound and lights at a concert.
No, that's what I'm saying.
Exactly. This game and it shoots. Let's talk about the way it shoots.
So, it still shoots.
Four flippers.
Yes. Yes.
Upper playfield.
Yes.
Triple decker playfield. Yes. It goes down the neck of the
guitar. The guitar. Two guitar necks.
And they have the assets and the licensing from some of the hardest musical manufacturers.
Yes.
Fender.
Yes.
Right? You get the, I don't know all the terms, but you get Les Paul. You get all of the brands.
Yep.
Emboldened it has on there like from the GNR.
Actual, like, it has drumsticks that the ball rolls
His
down.
Drumsticks.
Yes.
On the CE, the drummer signs them.
Yes. It is phenomenal. And it still shoots. Now, I will say, it still shoots like a Jersey Jack. It still has a softer feel
compared to
it,
like a Sterner.
But with it being a standard body, it still shoots very good. It
shoots better than Pirates.
I think so.
It shoots better than Pirates, and Pirates is one of the best shooting wide bodies of all time.
And that's what I'm saying about bringing it back to that standard
shoots
body.
Shoots better than Wizard of Oz, shoots better than Hobbit.
Yes.
Does it shoot better than Dialed In? It might.
It could.
That is very true. It might shoot better than
Dialed In. I'll tell you, Wonka is one of my favorite shooting games.
It's not as brutal as Wonka.
No, it's not as brutal as Wonka. But these shots that they have on here, Eric in a standard body was still able to take the magicalness that he had in Pirates with like hidden shots and just shots in places.
They're coming to get you. Do you hear them?
I do hear them.
Sirens.
You been Never drinking, mind. Boy? I reminded me of a story. Remember a streamer that we had and some sirens and stuff that started going off on our very first streamer that we had with us on Twitch? Remember that whole fiasco? That's what it reminded me of.
Boom.
That was amazing.
It's a crime the way you opened that pinball.
That was insane. But So back to, but these shots and stuff, they're shots in places and they come out and do things just like pirates, but on a standard body that you're not expecting, which is phenomenal. It's a game that you want to explore from the very first time that you shoot it. Yes, you
keep going. There's diverters. There's upper play fields that are fun. That upper play field is a blast.
It is neat.
You can try to hit it into the vuck, or you can try to hit it into your lock shot. Yep. Six ball, physical ball lock on the neck of that guitar, Greg.
Yes.
Inner loop shot. Even the freaking, like the pop bumpers are cymbals.
The pop bumper cymbals is one of my favorite things. That is magical. Magical in every way.
It's when shit like this happens, when you see him play games like this.
Yes.
That's what makes me go back to thinking, Jersey Jack Pinball, they just are a little different.
Yeah.
Like they just, like
they push the boundaries and push the envelope a little better. It's like they're not real. There's like, there's no restraint.
It doesn't feel like it.
It's like Eric is given the opportunity. Here, Eric, you create. And this is what you get.
I don't know if anything got pulled or not, but this game is great. This is a shilling. This is a shilling.
I'm not shilling shit. It's just awesome.
I don't give a fuck. Because I'm in on the CE, and I'm going to be playing that thing, and people can be screaming behind me, shill, shill, shill. But guess what? I'll be playing that son of a bitch until 2, 3 o'clock in the morning. I don't care.
I was like, you know what, man? Like, I kind of want this game because I like GNR. I like it. But I'm going to have to do my normal standard, especially because JJP came in at a better price point with their standard on this. A
lot of differences between standard LE and CE.
And with the light rails and everything else and playing that LE, I was like, this may have to be like my first like $9,000, $10,000 game that I buy. And maybe weed out a few things just to get this, because it's like when we first played Pirates, all we could talk about was, I want to play it again.
Mm-hmm.
You almost dreamed about it. Truly, as a pinball person, you dreamed about wanting to play it.
Mm-hmm.
This was the same way. When we left JJP, all I could think about on my 5.5-hour ride home was, I just want to get my hands on that.
Yes.
I want to get my hands on that.
I know, and we don't have one right this second. No. I want one really... really bad. Any other mechanisms in it? What about the code? The code is cool because...
code is cool.
I was telling Keith Johnson when we were playing up there, I said, Keith, like, when you start a mode, you have to hit all the characters, get them all together to start a song.
Which is easier than what you think.
Yeah. Get them all together. It's pretty straightforward compared to some of the other Jersey Jack games.
Yeah.
Get all the characters, you start a song, you can select over 20 different songs on here. They are not family-friendly either.
No.
They come shipped with a family-friendly mode, but turn that son of a bitch off.
Yeah.
Because the integrity... of Eric Menier, he wouldn't put radio edits for, I think, 4 of the songs.
Yeah.
Because he said it's not right.
Yep.
It's not right.
And you know, one thing that Keith expressed to us that I thought was very true, too, was that, you know, there is the normal Keith Johnson depth of where there is some ridiculous shit. But the casual, I won't say casual, the
just a regular
pinball player. Yeah. The guy wants to buy one for their house or play on location or anything. Yeah. The hobbyist.
That or somebody gets having beer it, wants to play a kick-ass game.
Can step up there, understand this game,
figure it out.
Still have fun, figure it out, still play the song, still have a good time. And I equated it, and I think you looked at me like I was stupid. Maybe I was saying it to Ken. This reminds me of Simpsons in that way, because I always feel like Simpsons.
That look.
Do you not? Yeah. Like, and I'm going to explain it to you, and maybe I'm just far off, but I always felt like Simpsons had a ton of depth with pretzel multiball with the oh shit, what was the
alien?
You had a bunch of stuff going on, but your main objective, if you were just stepping up to that game, still had fun. Shoot the couch, start the modes,
lock
go
the
through your modes, lock the ball. Like there were still things that were very out there, but there was so much depth and underlining things to Simpsons that you can go for and shoot for that takes some exploration to find.
Yeah, but the different part for me is what I was talking about before when I was talking to Keith Johnson. When you start a mode, the song, so you can start a song, everything stops. It's almost like the stage is lit. It's turned on. Greg, the coding on this game, every song is uniquely coded.
Oh, and yes. Has its own not taken away from that.
Lighting
at all.
Features and rules and all of that stuff.
Yeah.
I told Keith, I said, I'm not blowing smoke up your ass. Every song feels like a wizard mode.
Yeah, they
everyone
do.
Feels
it really
special.
Really does.
And I just want to see what this song does. Or I want to see what My Michelle does. Or, ooh, I really want to see with Patience what that does. That's the biggest highlight for me is the shooting The innovation with lighting and sound and everything.
Yes.
And experiencing each one of these. And that's not counting the five different wizard modes or what.
Well, and you hit the nail on the head. Like, not only with Eric's shots do you want to explore the game, but you want to explore Keith's code.
Yes.
Like, you want to dive into that. But it feels like a fully fleshed out game if you didn't know what you were doing.
No, you can just... It's much more approachable than other games.
Yes.
This is a much more approachable game than Wonka, yes. Shot-wise.
Yes.
Much more approachable than Pirates, shot-wise. Yes. Dialed in, probably. Yep. This is not an incredibly hard shooter, but if you want to see all the code,
yeah,
you got to keep that ball alive.
Yeah.
The ramps are inviting, right? Diverter. Oh, that diverter that jumps it
everything
off that ramp
is very
to that side ramp.
There's not a shot that you or look at in that game and it's like, I dread that shot. Why do I have to hit that shot?
And the spinner, it actually spins. When you hit that thing.
Oh, the hat. Slash.
It spins.
Yes, yes.
The post. What about the translucent spinners?
The wait is over. A revolution in LED lighting for your pinball is finally here. Fully customizable, full spectrum lighting from Penn Stadium Lights. Order yours now at PennStadium.com.
Chrome it, brass it, black nickel it, candy chrome it, powder coat it. The possibilities are endless at pinballplating.com. Your pinball machine deserves the best. At Comet Pinball, you'll find the best variety of LED products with the best quality LEDs, and most importantly, at the best price. Your collection is begging for an upgrade. Order yours now at CometPinball.com. Check out Pin Graphics for the latest and greatest in pinball enhancements, power blades, blade skins, pin blades, and even more. Visit PinGraphics.com now to see what's available for your pinball machine.
The translucent pick spinners?
Oh!
That are clear, so when all the RGB, they spin, they're clear.
And it almost clear. Reflects, yes. It takes it, it pulls in all the colors.
All the wire forms everywhere.
It is just a magically beautiful jam-packed
game. Before we let these people go, how do you feel about the standard being substantially lower? This thing is now cheaper, I think, than a Stern Premium, Greg Bone,
yes.
But it doesn't have the upper play field.
Yes.
Are you okay with that?
And it doesn't have the colored light rails. They're all
white.
They
give the hot rails.
Yes.
You get the lighting effects, but not the RGB.
Yes. I don't know. That's what I'm saying. Like, I feel like that guitar neck, all of that stuff, even just aesthetically, and you know me, I'm not a person that wants to pay for aesthetics, especially like over $2,000 to go up to the next thing. But I feel like that you get so much more with the shaker, with the
Visiglass,
with the powder coat, with that upper play field that's actually, like you said, it's a fun playing upper play field, with the hot rails on there that are RGB. Like,
it's tough.
The roving can lights, everything that you get. Yes.
Yeah.
Like, that to me is, it's like there's almost night and day, and you almost have to go up. You have to go up.
But how? That's a good value for the standard.
Oh, it's a hell of a value for the standard
machine. For the pro.
And I talked to some people that shot that standard more, and they said that it's like, you know, a typical thing when you remove an upper play field. Mm-hmm. It's kind of can
faster.
Be preferred because it's faster.
The guys at this factory said that they've been playing a lot of that standard.
Yep, because it's so fast and has so much more flow and stuff to it. So, you know, it's one of those things that if you didn't want to spend that extra money, that you're still not going to go wrong. You're going to have a very unique. Because I did that with AC/DC. I like the pro AC/DC because I like that speed and that brutality of those.
Oh, he just went off the rails. You were doing so good.
Just saying.
AC/DC pro.
Just saying. I don't mind it. I don't mind.
Is there a music pin that comes close to Guns N' Roses by Jersey Jack Pinball? Honestly.
Never.
Don't lie to these
people. It's impossible to.
This is in its own league, this type of game.
Yeah. Like I said, you were truly at that concert.
Super chill.
Yeah, not only do you have the concert footage, but you literally have all the assets that are on their jumbotrons that you would be watching at the same time that you're watching them perform. And what I saw on there a lot of times is when they throw the jumbotron stuff up on the LCD, then you still got Slash and everything over here in the corner at like an angle, and you still got the actual concert footage. So you're seeing literally as if you were at that concert. When you buy this pinball machine, it's like you have taken home a piece of that show to your home.
I think the Ellie is going to sell better than the other models.
Agree.
The collector's what I'm in on because I love that you not only get a topper, But part of the topper is another sound bar to like jam out even more.
Yeah.
You get that, and then you get the RGB. What they changed, Wonka CE had the red lighting under and behind. Mm-hmm. And they built it in, they recessed it. It looks really nice, right?
Very nice.
On Guns N' Roses CE, you get the chrome artwork, but the RGBs are on under the cabinet and behind. So that interacts, and the topper is RGB. So it all interacts throughout the game.
That's awesome, dude. I can't
believe it. And there's a coma. The CE does have an extra feature. We have not seen that yet.
Yes.
When you drain, you can save a ball through coma. Uh-huh. It's virtual on the standard and LE. Mm-hmm. But on this one, it physically locks a ball in your apron that you can see. You can physically see the ball stacking up inside the apron.
I can't wait to see
it. And it's got the glitter sparkles and stuff like
this. This is phenomenal. Beyond.
I want to go down to the Paradise City where the grass is green and the girls are pretty.
In closing, I cannot wait to play more of this game.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, absolutely. What do these people need to do?
Follow us. Like us.
Like physically?
Share us. No, don't stalk us.
You see them.
Follow us on Facebook.
Greg?
Yeah. Subscribe to us. Subscribe to us on YouTube as normal.
Motherfuckers going to pop up and Target.
Check out our video from JJP. Check out our interviews, man. Those were phenomenal with Eric and Chris, or with Keith and with Joe.
Special thanks to Ken Cromwell for helping with all of that.
Very much.
Communication was great. He's an asset up there.
Yeah, very
much. Just seeing the way he interacts with that team and stuff.
Very much so. And to the entire JJP team, man. You know, they stressed that.
They were
every time we talked to them, it wasn't, this is my game, this is my thing. They, every single time we talked to them, expressed that it was such a team effort.
Well, yeah.
From everybody, like people behind the scenes, everything. It was such a team effort. And there were so many people that it took to bring this game together.
Even like they have six coders now.
Mm-hmm.
Each one of the coders got to like choose their own song.
And work.
And that's why each song feels so much different, because different coders are doing
it. They get to put their own stamp.
Yeah.
It's phenomenal.
Yeah, follow us on Facebook. Follow us on YouTube. Subscribe and follow if you haven't already. Some really fun stuff coming up next. We need to get back into a couple more reviews. We need to do an Avengers review if we haven't done so yet. We also need to do a Rick and Morty review. We need to do a Turtles review.
Yeah.
We've got a lot of fun stuff.
We do.
Top tens, maybe a little this or that. Maybe we'll just listen to you rant. What do you think you're going to own next?
Honestly.
Oh, it's tough.
I don't know.
Oh, it's tough. These things are shipping, I think. Yeah. I think they're shipping.
This has got me. This has got me. Because I haven't wanted to pull the trigger on the last couple of new games come out. And this one right here. If I can just get my mind around spending that money. My tight ass.
You can play mine.
It'll probably be this.
You can play mine.
No, I want to borrow one.
All right. Until next time, this is Greg and Zach from Straight Down the Middle. Oh, I'm not even going to call it a pinball show. Stay tuned. When we first walked into that beautiful factory up at Elk Grove Village. Is it not? It might just be me.
Okay.
Ready?
Yep.
What are we doing?
Guns N' Roses, right?